So in my group, we are synthesizing new compounds. The compounds never existed before, and we are studying their crystal structure, and we want to understand the structure property relationship. So we use a lot of a variety of diffraction techniques to really pinpoint the atomic structure of the compounds we make. And since we are making the compounds which are never existed before, we ought to use some creative synthesis methods. So non-standard, unconventional, as we call them, synthesis method we utilize in my group a lot. And then, you know, materials-wise, we are targeting the compounds which can be potentially used for thermoelectric devices in lithium-ion batteries, as a magnetic materials. We are targeting superconductors, photoactive materials which convert sunlight into electricity, and other energy-related materials. So in my group, we really want to combine those two approaches. So first, we want to discover our materials within the computer by using the various theoretical methods available. And we do have an ongoing collaboration with scientists at physics at Iowa State and our Ames Lab. But then once we have the idea of what kind of compound we want to synthesize, then it's an experimental work, and it's actually it plays a central role for the research in my group. So then, because we are a synthetic group, we do make our compounds, we synthesize them in the lab. Students in my group will learn how to perform synthesis, and it includes standard solid-state synthesis, but also unconventional solid-state synthesis. We use very creative synthetic methodology. So besides standard solid-state synthesis, where the materials have to be sealed into the silica tube, we also do use microwave synthesis, solution synthesis, or standard solution synthesis using Schlenk lines. We also utilize the technique called spark plasma sintering, where we load the materials inside the conductive graphite die, and we subject them to the temperature and pressure to produce well-sintered pellets, which are necessary for the property measurement. So students in my group, besides the synthesis, they will also learn about various characterization techniques. So we use X-ray powder X-ray diffraction and single crystal X-ray diffraction, and both instrumentations are available at chemical instrumentation facility here at our department. We also utilize the facilities available for us at national labs, at Argonne National Lab and Oak Ridge National Lab, where we acquire powder X-ray diffraction and neutron diffraction. If a student is interested in understanding the crystal and electronic structure of the compounds they made from the point of view of theory, we do have such an opportunity, and we also have an ongoing collaboration with the theorists from the physics department here at Iowa State. So collaborations are really important for the research we do. So through collaborations, we are able to understand the intercalation, how the intercalation of lithium proceeds in the layered lithium nickel borides. We were able to synthesize by using scanning transmission electron microscopy. Or we can study whether what oxygen vacancies has to do with the certain oxide being photoactive through our collaboration with researchers at UC Davis. So I strive to equip my students with the necessary knowledge about, you know, synthesis and characterization methods. But I also feel that it is important to give students a certain freedom in the lab to explore. So that's why I always enjoy one-to-one discussions we have with each of my graduate students in the lab or outside the lab on their research project. And those discussions, they typically happen bi-weekly, so where we are able to meet and go over the data and, you know, brainstorm. And I always encourage students to express their ideas and not just express them, but you know, try them in the lab. So our research entails that yes, one has to have certain familiarity with the literature. Because oftentimes this is an inspiration to the new reactions to try in the lab. So Iowa State has been a really special place for solid state chemistry research over the last few decades. And I'm striving to continue this tradition. My colleagues at chemistry department provide really a lot of support, so we have a lot of help from the research scientists and staff at chemical instrumentation facility. And overall, the atmosphere is very collaborative. I always can get advice from my senior colleagues on every aspect of my work. I really feel it's important to be available and easily accessible for students. But however, I also want to give a certain freedom. As long as our environment is, you know, safe and welcoming, this will give the student an opportunity to be creative. And so I think of myself as being more hands-on about as my advisory style.